Hello and welcome to my channel. Today in this video I am going to share how I created this crazy liquid motion blob background in Adobe After Effects. Before continuing, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing. Let's get into After Effects. Create a new composition. I am calling it as main. I am choosing a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 10 seconds. Grab the ellipse tool and with fill set to solid color and stroke set to none, create a perfect circle like this. Hold shift to create a perfect circle. Press P to bring up the position property of the shape layer and create keyframe at the start of the timeline. Move forward in time and change the position as you wish. Keyframe the circle with various positions as much as you want. The keyframes need not to be of same intervals, it's all up to your creativity. Now duplicate the shape layer. Since I want the circle to double up when it hits any side of the composition, so I am trimming the portions until the circle hits any side of the composition. Delete all the keyframes, change the color of the circle and keyframe the position of the circle to randomly as you wish. Create as many circles as you want, so repeat the process. I would like to create 4 circles. So finally, this is what we have. Now create a new adjustment layer. Make sure it is above all the shape layers. Search for Gaussian blur effect and apply it into the adjustment layer. Set the blur value to 50. And search for simple choker effect and apply it into the same adjustment layer. Set the choke matte value to 50. Select any one of the shape layer and head over to the layers menu. Then go to the layer styles and select inner shadow. Open up the inner shadow properties and change the opacity to 100%. Change the distance and size as you wish and also set the angle as you want. I am setting it to 300 degrees and I am setting the distance and size to 50 and 35. Now again head over to the layer menu and in the layer styles select drop shadow. If you want to change the values of the drop shadow, head over to the drop shadow properties and change the values. Now copy the layer styles in the shape layer 1 and select all the other shape layers and paste it into them. Now select all the layers and pre-compose them. For the background I am creating a new solid. Search for gradient ramp effect and apply it into the solid layer. Make sure the solid layer is below the pre-comp layer. Change the colors and the centers as you want. Now head over to the project panel and duplicate the pre-comp. Now bring in the pre-comp 2 into the timeline and offset the pre-comp 2 for 10 or 15 frames. Now open up the pre-comp 2 and select all the shape layers and press S to bring up the scale property. For the size variation, I am going to scale down the shape layers in the pre-comp 2 and I am setting it to 50%. Again duplicate the pre-comp 2 so we get the pre-comp 3. Open up the pre-comp 3 and change the scale value to 75. Now bring in the pre-comp 3 into the composition timeline and offset it about 10 or 15 frames. Turn on the motion blur for all the shape layers in all the pre-comps. To change the colors of the shape layers in other duplicated pre-comps, search for hue and saturation effect and apply it into the duplicated pre-comp layers. Change the master hue value as you wish. I am setting it to 30 degrees for the pre-comp 2. For the pre-comp 3, I am setting it to somewhere around minus 60. That's it. This is what we have for the final output. So this is what we have at the end of the day. Hope you enjoyed this video. I have playlists on tutorials for After Effects Premiere Pro, Photoshop and Lightroom. So check them out and comment your thoughts. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos. Like, comment and share. And thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching. This is Raudran signing off.